All right, so now I've turned the shirt around and we have our pre-prep shirt here. And if you haven't already checked that out, please do so. It's on the Coast Airbrush TV site here. It'll show you how to prep. In other words, I've saturated with the W200 transparent base and ironed it to get rid of that shirt nap. So if you haven't seen that yet, please do so. So what I want to do here is execute a tag name design, and I'm just going to do it in black and one other color. We do a lot of designs like this, whatever the alternative color is with the black, in this lettering style. I'm going to be using fluorescent pink with it, so I'm going to lay out the name first, so with the Wicked Detail black, and then go back in with the color. So let's see what that looks like. So I just kind of predetermined a name that I want to write on here. And again, the first stroke is just to lay the name out. So, and as far as positioning on a shirt, what I like to shoot for is somewhere around the, you know, I'd say 4 inches down or so as being the center of where my name will rest going up and down. Obviously, you can use either, you know, the collar, or you can use the sleeve lines here to see how far out you should go. But as far as like your horizontal balance, you want it to run, oh, I guess right about in here, which if you look is about 4 or 5 inches down would be your center right in there. So that's where I'm going to start. Some of you may find that you're going to need to draw this out. I find that that just kind of hinders the way that I like to work, the way that I flow. So I'm just gonna go in with the black and lay it out. So I'm gonna do the name Katie. So let's see how that goes. What you see me doing here, if you've ever watch me work or something, I like to visually lay out first with my brush, and then I'll actually visually lay out kind of where it's gonna go and the center of it. So it almost looks like I'm doing a little blessing on there, so, and so it never hurts. So, all right, let's lay this out. All right, so now I have my initial stroke down, and again, what I showed you on the other side as far as the thicks and the thins, I want to go back through and thicken up the strokes that I need to, all right? You know, I don't know if I've mentioned this, but one of the things that, you know, speaking about the Wicked line, that I really like is how it's so artist friendly, the palette that it has. Not so much, of course, in this case, we're only using two colors, but when you start talking about, you know, doing portraits, or you're talking about working on other surfaces, it's really nice to have that varied palette, not just, you know, the fluorescence and the pearls and the primaries and all that, but you're talking about specialized colors in terms of, like your umbers and your ochres and things that go well, great starting points to get your work going in the right direction. So just as a side note, want to mention that quick. You can see here too, the I, this is my lowercase I. On the other side, I did an uppercase I. If you remember me telling you about the E, in other words, like this, the E on the other side, I had a uppercase and a lowercase. The I also has the same kind of condition. In other words, if I'm doing an uppercase I, that means it's at the beginning of my word. Otherwise, I would use the lowercase like this with the looping top. All right, now I'm going to add a little bit of an element down here. All right, this is what is called a soft dagger stroke initially, because the process that I'm doing now is, hold on, let me just fix this real quick. There you go. Okay, the process that I'm going to do is that I'm going to have a color blend, and it's going to be going from black up into fluorescent pink, okay? So what I like to do is lay out my soft strokes first. I'm gonna finish with a kind of a dagger flare on the bottom. So in order to have that kind of a blend, I need these strokes to be soft, all right? And soft dagger stroke means that the tips of both of the ends of this flare out and sort of blend in with the rest of the shirt, okay? We got some soft dagger strokes. We're gonna build that up a little bit. All right, and then it starts to get heavier. And as I work my way down, like I said, I'm just gonna work into a kind of a dagger stroke flare. Kind of re-enhancing those, carry this out a little bit more. All right, and I like to add a couple little starbursts here in the same color on the bottom. Now these, for example, are where these were soft dagger strokes, these are hard dagger strokes, meaning that the ends of them taper to a nice fine point and they're nice and vibrant, okay? What kind of a flared center to that. I like to do a little concentric circle there. It's a nice touch. I actually got that technique from my wife, Jen. She actually airbrushed for a number of years, and she had a great sensibility for what kind of feminizes as a design. I don't know how else to put it, but gives it a nice little addition to it. So, and then we're gonna do the same thing over here. And this the dots are just to kind of give it, again, a little bit of a variety. So there you can see that my name's laid out. I've got my initial blend of the black going up. And what I'm doing now is just rinsing out my color. All right, so we've got the letters laid out. They're nice and crisp. Good variety in terms of our thicks and thins there. And again, this would be a production name design. In other words, one that I would do several times during the day. So I try to keep it as simple as possible. All right, so I've got my black rinsed out. I'm going with my fluorescent pink. First thing I want to do is continue this blend here on the bottom. All right, so I'm just building it up this way. Let's clear that tip off. All right, so now I want to do, I've got a nice blend that's moving up into the name. Now what I want to do is edge it like we did on that second style. I first showed you this as the first style on the other side, and then the edging is the second style, and that's what we want to do here. I don't want to carry this all the way up, okay? I want a nice fade, something gradual, but then I'm going to start to do that edging, all right? So we'll start over here. This you want to keep nice and crisp again. Now I find with the Wicked fluorescence too, there's no need to reduce this. The fluorescence just flow great. You know, one thing about the Wicked as well is that, you know, depending on the reduction, again, like I've stated before, one of the strong points of the Wicked is your ability to reduce it. You can treat any color kind of like a candy, so to speak. In other words, you can over reduce it, use it to lay over certain parts of your design, certain aspects of it, and it'll lay out there and won't affect the vibrancy of your other artwork on there, but will lay over as a nice addition in terms of color. So just another addition to what you can do as an artist with the paint. All right, so I'm just gonna keep edging this here. I'm going to bolster this just a little bit more. Oops, don't forget about in here. Like I said, basically I'm just edging it around. I think I got everywhere. So what this does is gives you a nice effect of, for example, you have this nice color blend into the letters, all right? And you also have this nice edging around it. So, and then balance this off, I'm also gonna put another starburst up here right in the middle, all right? But this time I'm gonna use the pink to do it. All right, so there you go. I'm gonna rinse my brush out again. and just quick highlights and we're done. I do like, I said before, I like that that starburst on the top. It gives it nice symmetry. I find myself, in terms of my design sensibilities, I like to have a nice, I mean, I like variety, of course, but I also like my designs to have a nice symmetry. In this case, that additional star on the top just helps that. So, all right, and we're just gonna highlight this. I've got my Wicked White here. Again, remember with your highlighting, less is more. If I were to use too much of this white and carry it too far down and be too diffused, it loses that. It's now a black letter with a white highlight, and it becomes a letter that's half white and half black. Just kind of hit some hot spots. All right, there you go. There's our completed tag lettering design. Now you can take this, use it in a variety of different types of colors. I love this design with the fluorescent yellow and the fluorescent pink and the Caribbean blue. Creates an awesome five color blend. Once you get the yellow and the pink together, you'll have a nice orange transition. Once you get the yellow and the Caribbean blue together, you'll have a nice kind of fluorescent green transition. This design works great if you're trying to put a girl name on there, a boy name. Depending on the colors you use, you can use blue combos, you can go straight black and red. It's really, really versatile. So I hope this really helped you out. And again, that full design, or that full alphabet on the other side, you should use that in terms of developing your own tag alphabet. And hopefully it will enhance your display and whatever you need to do. So hope you enjoyed this. Looking forward to doing some more work here at Coast Airbrush TV. Thanks.